Good evening, everyone. Not Swiss R. My name is Miss Atkinson and I'm here today to talk to you about the Computer Aided Design course. Have you ever wondered what Computer Aided Design is? Are you curious about the design and the manufacture of the products you use every day? Do you enjoy using computers? Then welcome to CAD and the industrial software we call Autodesk Inventor Professional. The CAD Parametric Modelling course is a vocational course which is equivalent to an A level. However, it is important to remember that it does not carry any UCAS points. You will learn about and become competent users of a range of skills, such as two-dimensional sketching along the X and the Y axis, and the application of dimensions and constraints such as tangent, coincident and concentric, and be able to apply construction and center lines where necessary. You will learn how to create 3D models from the two-dimensional sketches and assemble component parts. Rendering techniques are when you will apply materials such as woods, metals, and plastics and add textures to parts to make them look photorealistic. You will learn to read and create working drawings, which is an integral part of communication with manufacturers in industry, and drive component parts to ensure they fit together properly according to their specific dimensions. There are many areas of CAD to study, for instance, 3D sketching, where you will be plotting coordinates from geometries along the X, Y, and Z axis. It is important to realise that 3D CAD modelling is a large part of most industry sectors today. There's the automobile and aeronautics design, engineering, and manufacturing industries. The architecture industry, although this is not taught in school, and the medical prosthetics industry. For this part of the course, you will create a lower and upper limb which is to be assembled to a sheet metal foot. This prosthetic foot is then driven by an Excel spreadsheet to change its length according to the height of the prosthetic leg. If you are interested in animals and technology, then it is possible to combine the both industries and work with animal prosthetics. There are many interesting projects and sectors to explore, such as human prosthetics. This was a real-life project carried out at a local hospital where this gentleman's cheekbone was 3D scanned and reconstructed from a 3D printed prosthetic cheek. There are several industries who offer CAD within their specialist subject areas, such as Sheffield Hallam University, where students study the design and the development of sports equipment, and the London Metropolitan University, where students will have the opportunity to experiment with design and use state-of-the-art prototyping equipment. There are plenty of CAD job opportunities on offer, and locally too. These ones were sourced just last week. Just remember, the world's population is now over 7 billion, and more than half the population today are under the age of 30. Pupils in Year 7 are currently being trained to use CAD. When they leave school, they will have had 7 years of CAD experience and will be the next competent employees. So don't miss out and get left behind. Where do you want to be in 5 years' time? Thank you for listening to my presentation, and I hope it has inspired you. If you have any questions, then please ask.